Hello and welcome to my channel Spark Stenographer. Today I am going to deliver you a shorthand dictation from Progressive Magazine April 2019. Exercise number 14, words 840, speed 80 to 90 words per minute. So guys, ready for the dictation. 10 seconds. Start. We are meeting after a year to discuss our common problems. As you are aware, the Indian Historical Records Commission deals with all kinds of historical records. A scope of our deliberations is therefore wide and extensive. It will, however, be of advantage to confine ourselves to matters of first concern, and I am sure you will agree that these relate to questions affecting the national archives. In all countries, the national archives are the treasure houses of their historical wealth, and we in India can justly take pride for the extent and magnitude of our richness in the field. Our national archives contain a vast collection of records, but systematic series begin from 1672. Some of the latest records are as late as 1999. They therefore tell the story of nearly 300 years of a most interesting and momentous period of India's history. If what remains of the scattered records of Mughal period are added to these collections, we can say that our records go back to the 15th century. There are not many countries which can claim records which go so far back. From the point of view of quality, also ours is one of the biggest collections not only in Asia but in the world. I cannot give you the exact number of our records, for much work of indexing and cataloging still remains to be done. But to give you some idea of the extent of the collection, I may say that if all these records are assembled in one place, there is no building in India big enough to contain all of them. It is hardly necessary for me to stress before the present audience the importance of national records. Such records are the basis of history and can alone give authenticity to our knowledge of the past. We read of the past, we are often troubled by the fact that our knowledge is neither complete nor adequate. Contemporary historians hardly ever leave accounts which satisfy succeeding generations, and in fact, they are often not in a position to judge what should be recorded and what left out. If, however, complete records are available, the annals of the past can be reconstructed, but in most cases, such records of the past do not exist. We know that during the Mughal period, India has the instruments of civilized law. During the 19th century, the European states adopted the convention that all state records should be open to the public after a lapse of 50 years. The records of the Napoleonic era were thus released to the public in about 1870. The Napoleonic era was a period of great progress in different fields, and it was described contemporaneously by many well-known historians. In fact, all the known methods of history writing were used in making the Napoleonic period vivid to the public of the day. But even then, when the official records became available in 1870, it was found that our knowledge of the period was both enriched and altered. Much new light was thrown on obscure incidents and happenings. Many old opinions had to be revised in the light of the new information. Similarly, the official papers relating to the so-called Indian Mutiny of 1857 were released in 1907. The Government of India published a 3-volume history of a mutiny based on these records. It is true that this book was written from the British point of view and did not therefore do full justice to the Indian participants. It is therefore necessary that these records should be examined afresh and a true account of the period written in as objective a manner as possible. Even when the official history, which was based on these records, revealed many facts that were previously unknown and corrected many of our wrong ideas about the different characters who participated in these momentous happenings. These two examples show how essential records are for a true interpretation of history. If, however, the records are to be utilized to the fullest extent, it is necessary that they should not only be preserved but also arranged and classified systematically. There must also be sufficient number of scholars with the necessary knowledge and scientific attitude to take full advantage of the information contained in them. In our national archives, we have an immense storehouse of such records, but two things have stood in the way of our utilizing them fully. One, we have not been able to make arrangements for all the records to be kept in one place. And two, we have not been able to appoint the staff necessary for the completion of the work of classification and indexing of the available records. In 1998, I had intended that the Government of India should undertake this task at an early date, and accordingly, a scheme was drawn up for the improvement of the tempo and the quality of the work later. Stop.